Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and this one's actually quite an exciting one. I think you guys are going to really enjoy this one. Some of you might not already know, but with a recent update, Vibroswords can actually now use weapon tunings, and all of the weapon tunings work on the Vibroswords. So that includes the really good ones like the lightning weapon tuning, but also some really funky ones like the strap attachment tuning and that kind of stuff. And I'm going to show you guys some of the best combinations I was able to come up with in this video. I'll show you guys four tunings, and I'm going to be using Beskad as my sort of model Vibroswords, only because the sword itself is very simple, like there isn't much flashy stuff going on with it. It also just has a really nice aesthetic design, and I think you can really build upon that design by having a cool visual effect with the tunings. So I'll be using Beskad, but one thing to note is with different Vibroswords, the tuning actually has a different effect. Like for example, the overcharged effect will have a different look on the Dark Honor Guard's Vibroblade than it will on like Beskad, for example. The reason is because the Vibroblades are very different. And so I just think that's really cool. Like it allows for us to really experiment with trying different combinations and seeing what really fits with our characters and stuff. You can be really creative with this stuff, and I definitely suggest you go home, get in collections tab, and try out some different combinations, see what works for you. I decided to use Beskad just because I thought it was one of the coolest Vibroswords and really plain looking, and I'm gonna show you guys some combinations here. So the first one I want to emphasize is the damaged weapon tuning. Now this damaged weapon tuning I find is quite underwhelming on lightsabers or on blaster rifles and stuff, but it looks really nice on Vibroswords. So check out what this thing looks like. One thing to note is when you sheath your weapon, the effect actually stays. And that's the same on like lightsabers and stuff too. That's not just exclusive to Vibroswords, but I just noticed that now. So I think that's pretty cool. But the second thing is, just look at how this looks. I mean, it looks like a fantastic weapon. It looks menacing, it looks dark. It doesn't necessarily look damaged. It just looks a lot cooler with the effect. And it looks more like something you'd see maybe in Lord of the Rings or World of Warcraft, so not necessarily Star Wars-y, but I'll show you guys with some of the later weapon tunings that you can really have a nice sci-fi bend to the weapon itself. But I just think with a damaged weapon tuning, this thing looks bloody awesome. The second one I'll show you guys here is actually with the lightning weapon tuning. So an oldie but goodie, and I think the lightning weapon tuning is the nicest thing to use with this specific Vibroswords with Beskad. And the reason I'll say that is because check out what it looks like here. It just looks like a sword encased in a ball of lightning. And I just think that's cool. That's just the basic thing. Now, the reason I don't necessarily like the lightning tuning on other Vibroswords like the Cathar Honor Sword, which I'll show you guys a little bit later, is because the lightning effect never extends up the entire blade. It just goes up like one quarter. On lightsabers, it goes up like one quarter the way. And I just think that doesn't necessarily have the coolest look. But on Beskad, for some reason, it goes all the way up to the top. So your entire sword is just encased in lightning. And the third one I'll show you guys here is with the Technolith Matrix tuning. And this is what I meant when I say put a sci-fi bend to it. So what you guys see on the blade itself is actually just the normal overcharged effect. So for example, the overcharge tuning, the Technolith Matrix tuning, the Indigo Fog tuning, all of these weapon tunings have a basic kind of generic overcharged effect to your weapon. And it looks different on, you know, blaster rifles, on lightsabers and stuff. On the Vibroswords, it basically just looks like the little bit of blade above your hilt is glowing. And it's a really cool effect. But what's cool is also the actual matrix red kind of tuning effect extends down the hilt. So not down the blade, but down the hilt of your weapon, as you guys can see here. So it basically looks like the hilt of your weapon is encased in this sort of, I don't know, like sci-fi technology. And I just think that also makes for a very cool looking weapon. I wouldn't necessarily say it's nice. It doesn't really appeal to me, but I just think it looks really unique. So if you want to make your weapon stick out, that is definitely one way to go about it. So I think it's quite a cool combination. And then the fourth and final one that I'll show you guys here is, I have to show you guys the volatile weapon tuning. Now the volatile tuning is just hands down one of the nicest weapon tunings. It always creates a really cool mesmerizing effect on your weapon, and it's no different on the Vibroswords. I mean, it's just a really cool effect. It gives the Vibroswords this cool kind of unstable thing where it just has these jolts of blue lightning shooting out of your weapon. And it's similar to the lightning effect, but two things. Firstly, I think the lightning effect is nicer. I just think the volatile effect, it works really well with lightsabers, not as well with Vibroswords. But the second thing is, I do think the lightning tuning changes with your crystal color and the volatile tuning doesn't. So if you have a different crystal placed in your Vibrosword, your lightning tuning should, in theory, change, because it does so with the lightsabers. And so it should with the Vibroswords. I probably should have tested that before making this video. But anyways, the volatile tuning, I know for a fact, doesn't. So that kind of, I think, puts the lightning tuning ahead. Anyways, the point is, those were four combinations that really stuck out to me. I tried them all on various different Vibroswords. And really, let me tell you guys, it is quite fun to experiment with this stuff. Like, it really, I spent a couple of hours just being creative with this stuff and seeing what really worked. And this was what stuck out to me. I think Beskad is one of the nicest Vibroswords to use this on. Some of the other really nice ones were the classic Vibroswords, is quite cool. The Dark Honor Guard sabers that were recently released, the Vibroswords, those are quite cool to use as well. Ones that didn't quite work out with, like, Cathar Honor Sword. I'll show you guys what that looks like at the end of this video, just because I think a lot of people might be looking at that, because that's kind of the go-to really nice Vibroswords, at least it was in the past few years. And it's also really affordable. Like, you can find a Cathar Honor Sword on the GTN now for like 3 to 5 million credits. It used to be like 20 to 30, but now it's 3 to 5. And so, yeah, you know, a lot of people might be going to that. I just don't think the Cathar Honor Sword works very well with a lot of weapon tunings. Beskad's a lot nicer. The classic Vibroswords a lot nicer. The Merciless Raider's Vibroswords isn't half that bad. Especially considering it has its own laser effect. Anyways, what I'm showing you guys on this video is actually just going through some of the other tunings, just to show you guys that the other tunings do indeed have an effect on the Vibroswords. I just think the other ones are a little bit underwhelming, like the Gemini effect, the Rakul effect, the Galactic Command effect. I mean, they have an effect, but I just don't think they were the nicest. They don't quite work with the Vibroswords, in my opinion. But nonetheless, that doesn't necessarily mean you guys won't like it, so I definitely, you know, say go check it out, see what works best for you. Let me know in the comment section what combination you guys like the most, whether it was a combination I came up with or something you came up with yourself as you were playing. I am actually interested to see some really cool stuff, maybe try out some stuff that some people suggest that I haven't already looked at. The other thing I also want to say is, I'll show you guys what it looks like on the Cathar Honor Sword here. And yeah, the Cathar Honor Sword itself already has this sort of visual effect near the hilt. But I think what it goes to show is that it doesn't work with every weapon. It's quite specific. You have to find a good Vibroswords that works with the weapon tunings. I've probably gone a little bit too in-depth and a little bit too passionate about this, but I just think it was really cool. I had a lot of fun trying it out. And, you know, props to BioWare for finally doing this. I've been waiting kind of... I had given up on it. I did not think BioWare was going to make it so that the Vibroswords can use weapon tunings. But now, I think like 90% of them can. There are still 10% of weapons, like the Gamorrean Axe. I wanted to check that out, but that one actually doesn't have a weapon tuning slot, unfortunately. So not all of them work, but most of them do. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and are excited about this change. And I will see you guys in the next one.